All these new developments out of the deep state from the Hill. John Solomon, Fox News contributor, Sarah Carter. John, we start with you. You have a huge story you are about to unfold. I've got some, well, let's just say a preview of coming attractions here. Tell us about it.
Yeah, so I'm putting the finishing touches on a column I think will come out tomorrow. And I will reveal two really important things. The efforts to begin targeting and reaching out to Trump campaign officials to gain intelligence on Russia that would ultimately justify the investigation began weeks and maybe months before the FBI had a formal predicate. And that's very important. The rules say you can't use sources until you have a predicated investigation. The predication is July 31st, 2016. My sources and documents that I'll be able to make public tomorrow will show that there were contacts going on by people identified as informers, informants, people who provided information began much, much earlier than July 31st. That's the first part. Second part is, as the investigation was just starting to ramp up, there are internal FBI documents showing FBI agents talking about the White House trying to take over the investigation, fears that the Justice Department was going to leak for political reasons, and their own personal fear.
When you say the White House, you mean the Obama White House.
Yes.
They were attempting to take over the investigation.
That's what these messages say. The White House is going to be in charge.
These are FBI messages.
Yes.
And we're talking about the Obama White House. How high up are we talking about here?
We don't know. The text messages are just what they are, right? They don't give a lot of detail. They're short and as you would normally see in a text message. But the words, the White House is running this, are clear in the text message, and people will be able to make up their own mind. And here's another thing that's going to be really interesting to people. You just had it in your monologue a little bit about whether President Obama was aggressive enough on Russia. The FBI agents who opened this case feared that Barack Obama was weak on national security and wouldn't do what they needed for Russia. You're going to see those messages tomorrow, and I think people will be able to see those in between
these
those bookend events.
These are struck page texts?
Some of them are struck page texts, some are other documents.
And
some
are. Yeah, and there's about to be, am I wrong, a cascading flow of information when the IG report comes out. Let me bring Sarah into this part.
Yeah, 400 pages.
Right. That the IG is going to release, and it will immediately be followed up by good people in the FBI and in the intelligence community that will corroborate and confirm this was rigged, this investigation into Hillary Clinton. Sarah.
Yes, there are a number of people that are ready to speak, a number of FBI agents that are currently working in the Bureau, and other former agents who want to tell the truth about what was going on. I mean, Sean, we know what happened at the higher levels on the seventh floor of the FBI, the highest officials, but there are so many agents within the Bureau that were disgusted by what happened. I mean, I reported over and over again, I know John has too, that agents were so angered when Comey made this decision. A decision he shouldn't have made, by the way. It should have been left up to the Department of Justice, that they literally got up from their desks in some field offices, left their offices and didn't return until the next week. Other agents were throwing food at the television at Comey. So, I mean, there are a lot of people that are ready to talk. They're ready to talk about what happened. It just depends on if Congress calls them to testify. And I think that's very important.
John.